Now, ATMs make it quite convenient for consumers to withdraw as well as to deposit some money 24 hours in a day, right? But unfortunately, withdrawing money from ATMs comes with a risk. According to South African Banking Risk Information, millions of rands are stolen each year through ATM card scams. And to talk more about this, we're joined now by Tinus Erasmus, who is the Bank Fraud Risk and Integration Officer at African Bank. Tinus, thank you so much for your time and good morning to you. I don't want to have this conversation with you because I am with a bank, I have a card, but it's so important because you and I might be at risk of a scam. What's some of the latest scams that we need to look out for?
Good morning, Tumelu, and thank you to eNCA for having African Bank and myself here this morning to, you know, be allowed this opportunity to educate our customers out there. And like you rightfully said, Tumelu, you know, myself and yourself, we're customers somewhere, and we've got money that we want to use on a daily basis at ATMs. So allow me to touch on that just briefly. If you look at ATMs and the risk that it brings in, unfortunately, one of the most prolific fraud types that's out there today, and it's increasing on a daily basis, is ATM fraud. So what that means is that customers fall victim to physical crime. You'll have a gentleman approach a customer attempting to withdraw funds at an ATM. And this gentleman will be very respectable, looking very nicely, probably in a suit and tie. Some instances we've even seen security guards pitching up at ATMs attempting to help. What they'll do is they'll act like they want to assist a customer that cannot get the card into the ATM slot. But what they're actually trying to do is shoulder surf over your shoulder, look at your ATM pin that you're trying to enter at that point in time, and also obtain your card. Mm. So they'll do everything they can and be as nice as they possibly can to be that jolly old good fella trying to help you out. But all that they're really trying to do is steal your money.
Right.
And how they do that is very simple, actually. They've got some sort of a trapping device inside the ATM slot, in the card slot we inserted. It will go in quite difficultly. So when you as a customer try to insert it, this person will wait probably a meter, 2 meters away from you, just off your right-hand shoulder or left-hand shoulder, and they will then enter themselves into your close environment where they will act like they are going to help you to insert your card into that ATM. If and when they do that, they have already shoulder surfed your PIN, like I mentioned.
Right.
So they've got your PIN. All that they now need is your card.
Okay, so with all that being said, Tinus, if I could just jump in there, what do we do then? Who do we trust to assist us at an ATM when withdrawing or depositing some money, and how can we look out for some of these scams?
So what you need to do is when you're at the ATM, you need to know that you are the only person that can protect yourself at that point in time. So the very first thing to do is never allow anyone whatsoever, doesn't matter if that person's in a security outfit, a police outfit, doesn't matter who they are, never allow anyone to assist you at the ATM. There's no one that can assist you at that point in time. So that's the first thing to do. Make sure that you always are secure and that your surroundings are safe. The first thing. The second thing, and although this might sound very simple, but the second thing to do is make sure that you protect your PIN by any means necessary. So when you insert your PIN, as simple as just take your one hand and cover it over the other hand to make sure that no one could possibly see your PIN over your shoulder.
Right. Now, we're talking about someone that we could actually see here in this instance. But before I let you go, I want to touch on also some of the invincible, people that send us online SMS. I'm sure you've received a text or two saying you've either won money or they come from a reputable financial institution and they would like to change your password. You need to offer them certain sensitive information. How do we know if that information or that request is legitimate or not?
Very simple, same as the ATM fraud. Never trust anyone. Never divulge any of your personal security information to absolutely anyone. So if you receive an email or an SMS requesting you to insert your PIN, your credentials, your login credentials, whatsoever, do never disclose that to absolutely anyone. It's your personal information, and you are the only person that's rightfully entitled to having that information,
All
not
right.
even anyone in the banking environment.
Heard you crystal clear. Thank you so much. Tinus Erasmus joining us there and giving us some banking tips so that you don't fall victim of some of the scams that we're seeing, especially at this time where you cannot afford to lose any money whatsoever. But let's move to this now.